Anybody who has had a wound or a surgery will be familiar with how things go. First, there's a lot of pain. Then, as the pain slowly moves away, another sensation takes over. It's not as hurtful, but it could be just as disconcerting. It's the itching stage. And people who would let their instinct to scratch away get the best of them may be in for an even longer healing period. Worse, it could even bring complications. Experts say itching is part of the healing process when it comes to wounds from an accident or a surgical operation. Why is this so? We have the answer, of course. But first, please don't forget to give a like to this video and to subscribe to our channel. It will inspire us to create more fun and informative videos just for you. When you get into an accident that results in an open wound or scraped or burned skin, the first course of action to take is to stop the bleeding. You also need to make sure that infection doesn't set in, so you have to clean and disinfect that wound. Your body on its own does its part to minimize the damage and to start the healing process. Its first order of business is to stop the blood flow out of the wound. It's a process known as vasoconstriction. Blood supply toward the wound is simply cut off, and a blood clot forms. With the blood clot come what are called fibrinogen proteins that come from plasma. These proteins crowd the wound to close it. This is what we all recognize as a scab. In the next few days, the pain from the wound will persist, but that sensation will soon be joined by itching. During this period, inflammatory cells have worked their way toward the wound and help clean up its base and prepare it for the production of new cells. Among these cells are histamines that aid in opening up the vessels around the wound so that immune cells can do their job of cleaning up the area. Histamines, unfortunately, are made up of a chemical that causes itching. If the wound gets infected during the healing process, there will be a lot of itching as inflammatory, and immune cells need to work harder as they fight against bacteria. What's more, new nerve connections are also being created to join the old ones. This brings about a mechanical reaction that causes additional itching. Experts think that itching can also be caused by a misunderstanding between the brain and the nerves under the skin. The signal sent by the nerves may be saying that collagen synthesis is being done as part of skin regeneration. But it could be interpreted by the brain as an itching sensation, which is what you feel in the wound. So that's why wounds in the process of healing itch. Medical practitioners have emphasized that no matter how itchy the wound may get, you should never scratch it or even give it a gentle rub. They say scratching can destroy the delicate new layers of tissue that have been formed on the wound and set back the healing process. It will also cause scarring, or worse, let bacteria into the wound and cause an infection. This is also true for surgical stitches that were made after a surgery or to repair a traumatic wound. Instead of scratching, what is recommended is to apply cold or warm compress on the healing wound. It would also help to moisturize it or apply an anti-itch cream. Don't wear tight clothing or accessories around the wound. To make sure you don't do damage to the wound by unconsciously scratching while you sleep at night, you can wear gloves. Some people believe that wounds exposed to the air heal faster, but experts say it should be the opposite. Once the wound has been cleaned and disinfected, it would be better if it's covered with antibacterial plaster until it is completely healed. Of course, there should be regular cleaning of the wound and a fresh change of plaster to prevent bacteria from breeding. We hope you have found this latest episode of Aha, So That's Why highly informative. Please let us know what you think in the comments section below. Don't forget to like it and to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.